Hello everybody and welcome back to the channel. So I have some exciting news to share. Over the past couple of weeks I have been working on the Phenom 100 EV enhancement mod. Now for those who don't know, Cockspur have made a payware Phenom 100 which released earlier this year, and it's quite reasonably priced at only 27 euros. Now this is one of the better light business jets in Microsoft Flight Simulator right now, and if you just look at it, it looks nice. The 3D model is absolutely great and the interior model is also great. It doesn't feature any type of EFB or tablet, though it does have a very kind of neat checklist that you can kind of open here, but it's generally quite a good add-on. It has the Garmin G1000 and the autopilot works quite well, and it also has some custom FADEC logic programmed in. Generally speaking, this is actually one of my favorite add-ons in Microsoft Flight Simulator, though if you look at reviews, the common problems that people tend to mention with this product is that the sound a bit terrible, and also the flight dynamics is a bit strange. Now, in terms of the sounds, FT Sim Plus released some payware sounds on his Patreon page for this aircraft, and that's what actually made me come back to this aircraft, because if we listen to the vanilla sounds here, well, I'll let you be the judge. But if we listen now to the FT Sim Plus sounds, they sound good. So this made me think, damn, I really want to come back to this aircraft. But when I was flying it, I did kind of notice that the flight dynamics were a bit strange at times. A lot of the problems I had when landing specifically was that I would thrust idle and I would flare and the aircraft would float down the runway. And I noticed that a lot of YouTubers when reviewing this also had this exact same problem. Now, in all fairness to Cockspur, I did mention this to them and they did say that they have verified this flight model with a real Phenom 100 pilot, and now I am not a real Phenom 100 pilot, so I cannot say if this is accurate or not, but regardless of if it's accurate or not, it's not very fun for me when I was going down the runway and basically just looking at the end of the runway, especially when I was on VATSIM and stuff. So I thought, let's modify this aircraft and make that stop happening. So I went in and I tweaked the ground effect and how the flaps sort of reacted, and I actually solved the problem. And then when I was landing this plane, it was now landing quite smooth. And if I compared this to actual real YouTube videos of the Phenom landing, it was actually now a lot more closer to that. So I thought, that's good. But then it got me thinking, well, the next problem I have with the Phenom, and this is nothing to do with Cockspur, because I actually believe they have simulated this bit correctly, but the aircraft feels a little bit underpowered. Now, I started Googling about this problem, and it is just a Phenom 100 thing. The engines were just a little bit underpowered. And then later on, the Embraer Phenom 100 EV. Now, the main difference with the EV that they addressed is they increased the engine power by replacing the engines with a Pratt & Whitney Canada PW617F1 E engine, which is basically the same engine but slightly upgraded. And this means that each engine produces 35 additional pounds of thrust. Now, that doesn't sound like a lot, but this is a very light plane and it's a very small plane. And trust me, you notice the extra thrust here. So now the Phenom 100 EV has a maximum cruise speed of 406 knots opposed to the default 390 knots, and it also means that you can now kind of cruise comfortably at around 380 to 390 knots, which is a lot closer to Mach 0.7 than the default aircraft. Now, the maximum Mach speed is still the same between the EV and the 100. You cannot go over Mach 0.7. So that is worth knowing. So it just flies faster. But also, they also made the engines more fuel efficient. So now not only could it fly slightly faster, but it also can fly slightly longer. And it has, realistically, around 130 to 150 nautical miles of range more. This depends on a lot of factors such as headwind and basically how much fuel you're burning in the actual flight, depending on where you put the thrust levers. Because this plane does not have auto throttle, but it does have FADEC. And this is where the big disclaimer is, and Cockspur have asked me to make this very clear in this video and in all of my mods, that they do have custom FADEC logic, which was coded for the original 100 mod, and that by me increasing the actual thrust of the engines, it may mess up their FADEC logic and may cause weird things to happen. However, I should note, even though that disclaimer is very valid, I have done a lot of testing on this mod. I've done 8 Wasm flights and I have not had any problem at all with the actual FADEC logic with the increased thrust, because of the way that I found to trick the aircraft into effectively dealing with the extra thrust. However, it should be noted, if you have any problems with the FADEC, do not go run into Cockspur and open support tickets with them. They would not be able to help you. This is a custom enhancement mod which is completely out of their control, and I am no way associated with Cockspur in any way at all, so just bear that in mind. With the increased engine thrust, it should also be noted that now we require around 65 feet less runway to take off, which is actually really cool because it means you can get out of smaller airports a lot quicker, and also you can get out of hotter airports quicker, which is very cool. Now, the only thing I couldn't really simulate from the EV in this mod is that the real 100 EV had the upgraded Garmin 3000, whereas the default Phenom 100 had the Garmin 1000. The reason I cannot change this is because it is a payware add-on and I don't have access to change the 3D model, because obviously it's not my work and I cannot redistribute that model. And also, there is some custom FADEC logic which is compiled in Wasm, which I don't have the original uncompiled code, nor do I have the permission to edit that code to actually change that logic with the Garmin 3000. So this still has the original Garmin 1000, which is a very capable navigation system. And like I said, I've been using this on Wasm and it's been absolutely perfect. But it is worth noting that this is where the difference really between the real 100 EV and my add-on kind of stops. It does have the old avionics on it. I also changed the markings on the actual plane, so it says Phenom 100 EV, and now this was done in collaboration with Zach B on FlightSim.2, who kindly agreed for me to repackage his markings into this mod, so big thank you to him. Adds quite a lot of immersion to this mod. So yeah, effectively that is my mod. You can download the mod for free on FlightSim.2. I also will pop the links for the Cockspur aircraft, which you can buy if you wish, and also I will link to the FT Sim Plus sounds, as well as to Zach B's FlightSim page, who did the markings for this aircraft. Now, I'm not claiming that this aircraft is perfect. There might be problems with it, and I do commend Cockspur for the great aircraft they have here. And this is just a modification on top to make the aircraft feel a bit more lively and a bit more fun. And it shouldn't be denoted that this aircraft is not perfectly realistic to the exact EV, but it brings it a little bit closer to it. So feel free, if any of you have any comments or feedback, feel free to comment here or on the FlightSim.2 page. I'm sure there'll be a few tweaks to this plane a little bit more as I sort of dive into it a little bit more in detail. But I just wanted to bring this add-on for this absolutely great plane that Cockspur have done an amazing job in doing, with the extra add-ons from FT Sim Plus and with my enhancement mod. It is becoming one of my favourite business light jets in Microsoft Flight Simulator, and if you guys are on Wasm a lot, you will see me flying this plane a lot recently. I will probably upload a few more videos to kind of show that if any of you are interested. But yeah, feel free to download this mod and let me know what you think in the comments. Thank you so much everyone, and I hope you have a wonderful day in the skies.